All right. At the next service call, I like to go inside first just to scope things out and see what's going on. So, went inside. She's got a Nest. She's got a Nest thermostat that she just had a electrician install, and it's not doing anything. So, well, let's see. Let me get my Vito and see if we have power where it should be and go. Red, white, and common. Red, white, common. Let's see if we have 24 volts. All right, red and common. Nothing. Let's do the white and red. 28 volts. Interesting. Sounds like we have no common hooked up and the batteries die in the Nest. For whatever reason, it's not working. There's no blue wire hooked up. Let's go see the boiler. Just giving it a visual inspection, making sure the relief valve is 30 PSI. Yeah, look at how they did this, by the way. See how the piping is just, the weight of everything is no bueno. All right, we have a bunch of relays here. Now she said this was for the radiant. There's this, and this goes to here. And we have common there, wired. The light is on. Common is hooked up there. Let's get our voltmeter, make sure we have 24 volts across R and common. All right, so I'm just testing. Sorry for the dim lighting. I'm testing between R and common. There you go. And I do have 24 volts, 28.8 to be exact. So, somewhere in this wire, all right, there is a short. And of course, then it goes into a finished ceiling. That sucks. Did you notice that? Did you notice what's wrong here? Before proceeding, tell me where the error is with this service call. If you're cheating, take a close look. Did you guess correctly? Or do you still not know what the issue is? I say this quite often, and that is, a good technician is observant of his surroundings. The answer in this particular case is that R and W, the red and white wires, are reversed. It's looking for 24 volts on R, but it's actually getting it on W. Watch. Okay, there's common. Here is 24 volts, which is R on the takeover relay. Bingo. Bingo was his name. So if you guessed correctly, I want you to say, got it. And if you cheated, I want you to say, I cheated. And if you have no idea what I'm talking about, say thank you. I made the red wire go to W. Yes, I can go down early and switch it around, but I'm too lazy. The red, which is 24 volts, goes to R, but it's the white wire. And now it'll work. And there it is. We have a charging battery. But wait, this gets better. There's radiant in this floor. They chopped open the floor to deal with the sewer issue. She told me that they fixed the radiant, right? So I noticed that this valve was closed and that valve was closed. So I was like, you know what, let me open them. And I noticed that the boiler was feeding continuously once I opened that up. So I decided to do a little investigating. So I went over here, I found that panel on this wall of graffiti, and I see they went inside here, and of course, there's water pouring from above because they never reconnected the PEX because you have to redo the whole floor. So, yep, all in a day's work. Well, it's Friday, 12 o'clock, time to go. Yeah, I thought I'll show you guys anyway. So they cut open the floor to get into the crawl space and cut all of the PEX. There's one there, there's another one there, and they probably go this way, and there's no fix of that. You gotta tear up the floor. You gotta tear up the floor. Yeah, okay. All right, no problem. This is a great example of running a service call and leaving no stone unturned. I was about to just fill out the invoice, you know, reverse wiring because it was wired improperly, and you know, battery and thermostat needs to be charged for, you know, at least a day before use. But I was like, you know what? Let's just go down to the boiler and let's just manually jump at TT and see what happens, what the end result is, right? And then I noticed the two valves that are closed. And then I realized, this is the radiant zone, right? And in the kitchen floor with a giant hole in it. I swear you can't make this up. I should bring out my version 3.0 sticker that says hacks bring me stacks, but can I make a repair to this floor? I'm not going through the expense. You have to chop up and expose some of the PEX, all the ends that are cut and put in couplings, and I'm not doing that. Sorry. I'll let someone else deal with that drama. All right. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's actually a good educational video because it shows you that you need to be aware of your surroundings. Now, I always say that a good technician is observant of his surroundings, which is correct. You know, I notice these little things and I retain them and I use what I see in the process of diagnosing what's the issue before me. Here, you know what? I saw the thermostat. I immediately tested R and C. I did not have 24 volts. Then I went downstairs to the zone relay and I tested R and C, and I had 24 volts there. And then I threw a curveball at you because I wanted to see if anyone noticed what I saw. So if you saw that, you know, pat yourself in the back and comment, got it. If you didn't see it, comment, I didn't know. And if you cheated, well, right, cheater. All right, it is Friday, 12:15. Time to go home and relax. Hope everyone is well. You and your families, be well, stay safe, God bless.